And we are back. And, you know, as I say, we're preparing to get rid of some stuff that we're not going to need to take with us. So now I'm going to clean up my steel MS-362 chainsaw here and get it posted for sale. It's kind of a shame to let it go, other than the fact that I'll have like three or four more saws at my disposal, so if I need one, I'm not going to have to go buy one. But it is a shame, because this one literally only has like 6 to 8 cords of wood. Has only cut like 6 to 8 cords of wood. So, anyway. I still got a few things I need to get together. And anyway, we'll get this thing cleaned up, started up. It hasn't been started since last summer sometime. Probably should have solved it before now, but anyway. We'll get the thing going and see what goes from there. Anyway, be back in a minute. So anyway, first things first, poor thing is just filthy. Apparently I must have been in a hurry when I put it away the last time. But it's just plain filthy at the moment. So wrong switch. Wrong socket. What, bud? Okay, you dug a hole. Good job. First step in cleaning it is to take it apart and clean out what we can. Right now I'm backing a chain off. Anybody that's been around the saw before really probably already knows this stuff, but here we are doing it anyway. One thing about it, since it is coated in all this dust and what have you, it's all oily, at least. So, you know, to me, if I was in the market for a used chainsaw, that's something I would actually want to see, because at least I know the chain's been getting oiled. This is a 20-inch Roll-O-Matic roller, and when I bought it, it actually came with this 24, which is a bit much for firewood in Nevada, basically. Anyway, just start scrubbing pretty much. Try and knock the biggest stuff off of it, of which there's a lot. And crannies and stuff, they'll be a problem, but that's why we have air. Plus that, and I was actually cutting fence poles with this thing the last time I actually used it. So I'm sure that didn't help either. They were treated fence posts. They just make a bigger mess, basically. Anyway, I have to fire up the air compressor, so it's going to get a little bit loud, but such is normal. Anyway, let's blow this bugger off. Actually, let's scrape this piece off. Scrape off our power head a little bit. got pretty much the worst of it knocked off there between scraping it out and blowing it out. I'll probably take a rag to it just for good measure. Same goes with the power head here. Just take a rag and wipe it down good. Make sure it looks decent. For now, I need to get into the air filter, which, if I can see what I'm doing here, is right underneath of this cover. Two little flathead screw tails here, quarter turn each, and off it goes. It's a lot of times easier to push the start top switch down a little bit so you can get it off of there. Oh, excuse me, three little quarter turn screws. It's been a minute since I've actually had this thing off. There it comes finally. So anyway, this is your air filter for the saw right here. And we're going to go ahead and blow that off a little bit before we actually take it off to blow it out. It's not too bad. We could probably get away with just blowing out the outer. Perfectly clean. They're a lot better than what they were. I usually try to do this about once a year when I was actually using this thing. As I said, I haven't quite been using it like I once did. What? Okay, so we got our, everything's kind of pretty well cleaned up here for what we're going to do at the moment anyway. We're going to go ahead and just put the cap back on. So, like I say, we're just going to put our cap back on and probably fire this turret off, see what happens. I'm expecting this is going to take a minute, so go play with that someplace else, okay? Because, like I said, this hasn't been started since back last summer. These screws can be kind of a pain to get back in, but they're there for a reason. Okay, so we have our compression release here, throttle here, just like always. That's your off position for your ignition system, and then full choke to start with. I'm gonna cheat. I don't have chaps or any of that other good stuff on because, well, we're just gonna start it up. It doesn't have a bar on it or anything else. We'll see what happens. As I thought, it's gonna take a minute anyway. Half and see what that does. That was easier than I thought. Choke. Steel doesn't want to start, and once it does start, it runs good. Get this done, and then we'll put it back together, show you the finished product. Anyway, we'll get back to you in a minute. And so here we have it. This is our freshly cleaned steel MS-362 chainsaw. It has the full wraparound handle on it, which is kind of a nice feature for if you're actually sawing trees down. You know, it appears used, not abused. That's about the most I can ask for it. As I said, the thing's only had about 8 cords of wood put through it. So, yeah, anyway, I'm going to list this booger. I'm going to list this thing for sale for, $350, I think. And, see what goes from there. But yeah, $350 for a chainsaw, the bar that's on it, the 24-inch bar that I have for it. I don't have a chain. the chain guard, and oh yeah, of course, files, and I believe I've got some gas over here for it too. Oh yeah, there's bar oil here, and some gas mixed up for it. In my mind, it's not a bad deal because, you know, there's oil, gas, saw, bar, chain guard, and, of course, the other bar, saw tools, all that good stuff. I think I've actually got some two-cycle oil for it, too. Yep, I sure do. See, four of these steel synthetic two-cycle engine oils. The only thing I really don't like about this stuff is it mixes 2.5 gallons at a time, and it's kind of hard to use up 2.5 gallons of mixed gas when all you got is the one thing that runs it. But anyway. Now to take some pictures and get this stuff put online. We will talk to you later, guys.